Hi kids, today we are going to enter into the new chapter, cost and revenue analysis. Cost means what the cost we are, that means we are spending to give the production, that is called as a cost. Revenue means income. Revenue means what? Income. Okay. First we will learn about the cost. Okay. Cost analysis. Cost analysis, in this one what we are saying is a total expenses incurred in the production of a commodity. What are the things that means we are spending there? How much money we are spending to give the production of one of the product? That is called as the cost analysis. That is called as the cost analysis. Already I told the four major factors of the production are land, labor, capital and production. Sorry, organization. Okay. Capital and organization, I told, isn't it? These are the major factors we are saying. In this one, capital, it plays a vital role. Capital is plays a vital role there. And also, actually, we are saying that land and labor are the primary factors. And these both are called as the secondary factors we are saying there. In this one, capital, why we are saying as here, why we are saying that it plays here. Vital role means because without the money we can't able to give the wages or otherwise give the rent and also make the profit also, because with the capital alone we are buying the tech machines, everything, isn't it? So how much we are spending on the product, on the production, how much we are spending on the production, that alone we are saying as a cost analysis. The functions, relationship between cost and output is expressed as a cost function. The function which the relationship between the what we are saying the output as well as in the cost. Cost and the output. Cost means what I am saying again and again. The money which we are spending to give the production, that is called as a cost. Okay. How much we are spending the cost, that means the money, to give the output. That relationship only we are saying as a cost function. We might denote this one as a C equal to F into Q. Okay, C equal to F into Q also we may say that. That means the functions of quantity. Functions of quantity only we are saying as a F into Q. C means cost. Okay. Here they are given the formula like this one. Total cost, it is equal to quantity. Quantity only Q. Okay. Q cube minus 18 Q square plus 91 Q plus 12. Here TC is a total cost, Q equal to quantity. Okay, we will move on to the cost concept. So, what are the cost concepts? We will move there. Money cost, real, explicit, implicit cost, economic cost, social cost, opportunity cost, sunk cost, floating cost, prime cost and fixed cost. These are the, so not only fixed cost, variable cost also is there. Another cost is the variable cost. First, we will move on to the money cost. What is the meaning of the money cost? Production cost expressed in money terms is called as the money cost. Okay. The production cost which expressed in the money terms, in the money terms, in the thing money, as it is what we are spending there, it only called as the money cost. Real cost. Actually, most probably what are the things it will come on the money means, we will say about the when we are buying the raw materials, we are spending the money, isn't it? When we are giving the wages to the labor, that also as a money only we are spending there. These all the things, wherever we are spending, as it is the money, it is called as the money cost. Okay, next, real cost. It refers to the payment made to all compensate the efforts and sacrifices of all factor owners for their services in the production. That means all the factors. Okay, well, all the factors of the owners, what they are spending, everything only it will come here. For money as it is, if you are spending means it will called as a money cost. Real cost means everything, land, labor, everything it will come on the real cost alone. That means the services, the labor we are giving, the money alone, isn't it? As a wages we are giving, but we are getting the services from them, isn't it? So that services, everything it comes under the real cost. Everything we may say, the workers, those who are working there, and the organizer, one who is thinking, the thinking also it will come under the real cost alone. Next, we will move on to the explicit cost. Payment made to others for the purchase of factors of production is known as the explicit cost. Okay, to purchase the factors of production, what the amount we are spending, it is called as a explicit cost. What are the things it will comes under? Wages, already I told, is it payment for the materials, rent for the building, interest for the capital, expenditure on transport, advertisement, and also license fee. Everything comes under the explicit cost. Next, implicit cost. Payment made to the use of resources that the firm already owns, that the firm already which it has having the, for that what we are spending, it is called as a implicit cost. For example, we may say about that the person, that organizer, he may have his own land. Okay, he may have his own machines. That means already he is having that, for that he is going to spend the money. What already he is having, for that alone he is going to spend the money. That is called as a implicit cost. Maybe he may have the own resources also. For example, I may say for the agriculture products, when we are giving the what is it one agro based industry, in that one agriculture products, the raw material also, maybe it may be made by the organizer itself. Okay, that also, that means what the amount is spending for that one. It, the things which already I am having there, for that also what I am doing there, I am spending the money for that to give the production. Okay, that is called as the implicit cost. Economic cost. Next one is the economic cost. Actually, it refers to all payments made to the resources owned. That means the implicit cost as well as the explicit cost, both alone. Okay, when we are adding this both, the economic, it is equal to the economic cost. That means we are purchasing so many things in the explicit cost, and we are paying the money to the whom, for the labors, workers, whatever we may say there, and we are paying for the license, and we are paying for the depreciation of the machineries, everything. Okay, everything comes under the explicit cost. Here implicit, what already we are having there, what the already having the things, for that when we are spending the money, it is called as a implicit cost, I told, isn't it? When we are adding this both, the economic cost we may get there. Okay, when we are adding the explicit cost and implicit cost, we may get the economic cost. Next, social cost. Actually, the definition given for the social cost by the Alfred Marshall is, social cost to represent the efforts and sacrifices undergone by the various members of the society in producing a commodity. That means when we are giving the production, one of the production of the commodity, various members, not only in the industry, maybe outside of the industry also, so many members, they may be involved indirectly in the production of the one of the product. Okay, that services, everything includes in the social cost. Okay, opportunity cost. Opportunity cost, it offers to the cost of next best alternative use. What next best we may alternatively can use, that is called as a opportunity cost. For example, what we may say, the farmer, he can cultivate paddy as well as the sugar cane in a land. Okay, if he cultivates paddy, the opportunity cost of paddy output is the amount of sugar cane output. Okay, that means it will be equal there. The opportunity cost for the, what we are spending for the paddy, it will be same as it is for the sugar cane also. Okay, this is called as a opportunity cost, otherwise the alternative cost, otherwise we may say as a transfer cost also. Because if you are, that means if you are cultivating the paddy, what the amount you are getting from that one, you may invest to cultivate the sugar cane also. To invest to cultivate the sugar cane also. So it will be called as a transfer cost too. Sunk cost. A cost incurred in the past and cannot be recovered in future is called as a sunk cost. For example, we may say about that the money which we spent on the machines, the money which we spent on the machines, and the money which we spent on the land, it will comes under the sunk cost. But land we can't able to say as a sunk cost. Why we can't able to say as a sunk cost means, land we can afterwards also we may sell it there. We will get the more money alone. Okay, when you are purchasing it, maybe you may purchase 1,000 rupees, but when you are selling it, it may be the land value, it may be increased. So land won't come under this one. Only the machineries, when we are spending the money, same money you can't able to get when you are that means when you are reselling it. Okay, reselling it, you can't able to get the same money. Definitely the depreciation, it will be occurred in that one. So only we are saying as a, that one as a sunk cost. Floating cost, it refers to all expenses that are directly associated with the business activities but not with the asset creation. For the asset creation, what we are spending the money, it won't comes in this one. But other than that, everything comes under, that means what are the cost we are spending in the production, everything comes under the floating cost. For example, we may say about the transportation charges, wages for the workers, and also the power, that means the energy, for the energy what we are spending there. Energy means here we are saying as a power, okay, electric power, what we are spending the money. Everything comes under the floating cost alone. Prime cost, all costs that vary with output together with the cost of administration are known as the prime cost. Prime cost we may say as a variable cost plus cost of administration. Okay, variable cost. Variable cost always it varies above, with the quantity. How much quantity we are giving the production. According to that, the cost also it will vary. Adding with that one, what the cost of administration, for the administration purpose, how much we are spending the money. Both included only we are saying as a prime cost. Fixed cost, it does not changes with the changes in the quantity of the output. Okay, that is called as a fixed cost. We may say this one as a expenses on fixed factors remain unchanged irrespective of the level of output. When we are giving the output, that means the output of the quantity, that production, it may be changed, but the fixed cost, it won't change at all. Okay, for example, we may say about the, when we are giving the salary to the workers, it is fixed, that payment, it is fixed. He may be giving the more production also, they won't take that one into their mind. How much production if they may give, let them give, but only the payment, it will be fixed. That is called as a fixed cost. Variable cost, the cost varies with the level of the output. Here we may say about the wages for the temporary workers. Okay, temporary, here permanent workers only fixed cost. The salary, it is fixed for the permanent workers. But for the temporary workers, how much they are giving the production, according to that alone, they will get the salary also. Okay, that is called as a variable cost. Thank you, children.